The first question that people usually ask me when they find out that I'm a life model is, so you're like, naked? Nude, actually, yes. And the reason is so that artists can learn to draw anatomy and practice figures without any pesky clothes getting in the way. I always wanted to be a life model, but I really didn't know how to get into it. And just like every other occupation, it seems like you have to know somebody. I had a friend who worked at a college that was looking for life models. I applied and I got the job. Life modeling is different from fashion modeling in that the artists are looking for people of all races, ages, shapes, sizes, genders, especially animators. Sometimes a really muscular person will be called on for an anatomy drawing class, and sometimes a more Rubenesque model will be called on when an artist wants to practice drawing curves. A modeling gig will generally pay about $15 to $20 an hour, depending on your skills and experience. Models are hired either as contractors or as part-time employees, depending on the school or the studio. Sessions are generally 3 hours long. Painting sessions are one pose for that whole time. Gesture drawing sessions are multiple poses, ranging from 1 to 20 minutes each. And sculpture sessions are one pose, but the model turns every time, every few minutes, so that the artist can see all the way around. Even with breaks every 20 minutes, models do get sore. It helps to alternate poses so that you're not stressing the same muscle groups every time. Physical challenges aside, modeling is one of my favorite things to do, even though I have ADD. I'm actually a huge introvert, so I love being given permission to just live in my head for 3 hours. I do have what you might know as bitchy resting face. So I try to think of happy things for 3 hours, and it's better than therapy. Tape is used to help models mark off where they were sitting and where their feet and hands went. Muscle memory also helps get you back into the same position after a pose, especially when you're like, oh yeah, that's where I'm the most sore. Finger placement is especially important because it's really hard to get back into the same position, so concentration helps. And if a model can get back into the same finger position, she will get mega brownie points from the artists. People usually assume that artists love to draw my hair, but that's not always the case because they want to focus on the figure, so I usually wear my hair up so that my neck and my shoulders are visible. There are always fans and heaters available for the models. My concern is generally that I'm sweating too much because I don't want the artists to have to draw that. I imagine that male models have a little bit slightly different concern about the cold. Models do choose their own poses for the most part, but sometimes the session managers will have an idea whether they want a seated, reclining, or standing pose. I draw on my experience as a dancer to help me choose my poses. The artists are always very professional and respectful, and I return that by keeping in mind their preferences, their styles, and their strengths and weaknesses and when I'm choosing poses. Every once in a while, an artist will offer to let me take home a piece of art, and I still haven't decided whether or not I'm going to hang it up on my walls. Only zits were photoshopped out of these slides. I left in things like fat rolls, cellulite, stretch marks, uneven skin tone, just to show that I have flaws, and everybody does, but we don't have to let that affect our confidence. I developed insecurities during middle school, just like everybody else did, but I've always been kind of a nonconformist, so my teenage rebellion took the form of actually loving my body instead of obsessing about its flaws. I do have that dream where you show up to work or school and you're not wearing any pants, but my subconscious mind says, so what? And just goes with it. And we only feel exposed when we think that we have something to hide. Once we accept and love ourselves, we realize we have nothing to be ashamed of, and that's the difference between being naked and being nude.